Konkanis are lovers of green leafy vegetables, and most of the houses will have their backyard garden with turmeric leaves, colocasia leaves, that is patrada pan, etc. Especially this plant, which is pumpkin plant, and the various parts of this plant is edible. The stem is used in gravy, the small buds are fried and it's very tasty. This leaves, pumpkin leaves, is very nutritive. It is very rich in iron and we make many dishes out of this. So today I am presenting a recipe using these pumpkin leaves, and it's a very crunchy fried dish called Dudhya Panna Podi. And now let's see how to make this tasty crunchy dish. So here are some fresh and tender pumpkin leaves, washed and rinsed thoroughly, and now it is cleaned properly and dried well. Let's check out what other ingredients are needed. So we need whole udit, it's the whole thing, not the dal. 1 cup of udit, 2 to 3 teaspoons chili powder, a half cup of rice powder. I'm using pink Himalayan salt as per your taste. The next is hing or asafoetida, and coconut oil for frying. Let's first dry roast the udit using very less amount of oil. Roast it till it is golden brown and you get a good fresh aroma. Let it cool and then grind this into a very coarse powder. The consistency should be very coarse so that it gives a crunchy texture to the dish. So this should be the consistency. So once the udit mixture is ready, we are adding the other powders as well. So first comes the rice powder. Next we are adding chili powder. Salt as per your taste. Next is asafoetida or hing. It just boosts the aroma. Give this a good mix, adding water occasionally. The batter should not be very thick or loose. It should be of medium consistency so that we can apply this on the leaves. So you can just see the thickness of the batter here. This should be the consistency. Rest this for about 10 to 15 minutes so that it just gets settled. After 10 minutes, we are going to apply this on the pumpkin leaves, and you can just check the consistency and add some water if needed. So this should be the thickness of the batter. Since we have added udit here, there is a chance of the batter getting thicker, and you can just loosen it adding some water. So now take the pumpkin leaves one by one and spread the batter all over the leaves gently using your hands. Once the leaf is fully covered with the batter, place another leaf on the top of it and spread the batter on this leaf also. Repeat the process and create 4 to 5 layers of pumpkin leaves spread with the batter. This recipe is my mother's specialty, and I always love to munch and crunch on these podis which my mother makes. Once the layering is done, just fold all the sides and apply batter on the sides also so that it's stuck tightly. I'm adding this recipe, which is a fried one and full caloried dish, because one of my friends wanted to have a recipe to gain weight. So this recipe is for my friend. Nutritive yet packed with calories. Okay, so once the sides are folded, just roll the leaves into a tight log and add the batter occasionally and roll it tightly and set it aside for another 10 to 15 minutes. Roll it tightly, otherwise the layers will get opened. Apply the batter generously on the roll so that all the sides of the roll will have the masala. Rest it for about 5 to 10 minutes and now we are going to slice it into very thin slices. Be very careful while slicing to see that the layers are not separated. Make sure that the slices are very thin so that you will get very crunchy podis, and the crunchier it is, the more tastier it will be. So you can just press the slices and see that it is having a proper shape and the leaves are not separated. Once the slicing is done, take some rice powder and coat these slices with the rice powder very well so that the layers will be intact, and at the same time this will also add an additional crunchiness to the podis. So once you are done with the coating of the podis, now we are ready to fry these in coconut oil. So heat some oil in a kadai and just deep fry these slices one by one till it is crunchy. Fry on both sides till you get the crispy sound and nice aroma. The podis are ready now. You can make sure that it's done from the crunchiness. You can hear the crunchiness. So the beautiful, tasty, crunchy Dudhya Panna podi is ready. I'm just plating this and we are now ready to taste this. You can have it along with the rice or you can just have it just like that. I'm just taking a bite of a podi so that you can hear the crunchiness. Hope you would have liked this tasty, crunchy and rich recipe. Thank you. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel, Konkani Chellyos.